Hello everyone! Today I'd like to make a short video showing how parsers are made. So yeah, let's jump right into it. A parser is a data structure that holds a computation, that takes a string and gives us something structured as a result. We need a way to run a parser. So let's have a function that takes a parser, takes a string, and gives us the result back. Parsing can fail, so we need to be able to return an error. And for simplicity, for now, we can let that be a string, but it could be something more structured. The parse function has given us a hint as to what should be inside the data structure. So let's just copy-paste that part of the type signature into the type definition and see how far that can take us. Now to make some actual parsers, let's start with a simple succeed function that takes whatever value we give it and just says this is the result of the parsing. And it will not look at the input string at all. Let's try it out. In our REPL, we import the parser module, and when we just evaluate the function itself, it gives us parser with a function in it, so we need to actually run it, and it gives us the result back. Similarly, we can make a fail parser that will ignore the input string and will always give us the error that we provided. If we try this one in the REPL, again, it gives us a parser back, which is function. And when we apply that function, apply that parser to whatever value, we get an error back. All right, so now let's make a parser that actually does care about the input string and does something about it. So the string parser will take a hard-coded string that it will look for at the current position in the input string. And if it finds it, it will succeed, but if it doesn't find it, it will fail. And since the string that we are looking for is hard-coded, static in a sense, we don't really need the parser to give that back to us, so we will just return an empty tuple. Now, when we try it out, if we run the parser on a string that starts with what we are looking for, it will succeed. But if it starts with something else, it will fail. All right, now let's take a look at how we can combine multiple parsers together, how we can run them in sequence. A pattern that you will usually see in functional languages is this pipeline style, where at the beginning, at the top, we start with a function that takes some useful parsed data and massages it into the final form. Right now we are ignoring the actual values because our parsers don't return anything useful. And you can imagine each call to keep to provide one of those arguments, while the calls to skip will run the parser and advance the input string, but they will not give a new argument to the function. So ideally, we would want the keep parser to run both the parsers it's been given in sequence and only give the second parser the rest of the string, right? But we don't have that right now. So we need to update our definition of what a parser is to say that in addition to the parsed value, it will also give us back the rest of the string. Of course, now that we have changed the core type that everything depends on, we need to fix a few of the functions. Mostly they didn't care about the string, so they can just return it together with the result. But in the string parser, we do want to advance the input string. So once we know that the beginning of the string agrees, we need to drop it from the input string and return the rest. And this gives us the capability to thread those two parsers together in the keep function. So now we can actually hold the rest of the string after the function parser and after the a parser. We now also hold the function and the argument. So let's apply one to another. And we return the result of that together with the rest of the input string after the second parser. The skip parser will be similar, but we will not care about the result of one of those parsers, just about how it advances the string. Alright, so this should work. Let's try it out. Let's actually write out those examples here in the text editor because it's easier than in the REPL. Also, we need to remove these parser dot qualifications because we are in the same file, so this would not compile. So let's expose those and try them out. So open the REPL, import the parser module. The example is a parser, and the results are as we have expected. Alright, so that's it for this episode. In the next one, if there's gonna be one, we can probably take a look at some more useful parsers, like one for integers or one that tries multiple alternatives. But yeah, that's gonna be another video. See you then, and happy parsing!